What the heck does my dishwasher have to do with your dental practice? Well, believe it or not, my dishwasher has a lot to do with your dental practice and my dental practice, the one that I used to own, and every dental practice across the world. So we're going to find out just what that means in a second. Welcome to the Dental Practice Fixers podcast. I'm Dr. Richard Amato. I'm co-founder of the Amato Center for Dental Practice Success, and we are based in beautiful Baltimore, Maryland, and we work with clients all across North America, every part of the U.S. and many parts of Canada. We've been working with dental practices, so we're here to help you, and hopefully you'll get some tips and tidbits and even some fun things on today's podcast. If you're watching us on YouTube, you might be able to see behind me, it's a beautifully rainy day here in downtown Baltimore, Maryland, but maybe where you are, it's absolutely beautiful. In any case, here I am from the end of the world to your town, as Elton John used to say. And let's talk about my dishwasher and find out what the heck my dishwasher has to do with your dental practice. I'm telling you, it's a lot. But before we get there, I just want to remind you that my favorite way to save money every single month is by not paying an overage fee for your credit card processing. Why pay a credit card processor a percentage every time a patient wants to use a credit card? Don't do it. Don't do it. Use Stacks by Fat Merchant. Why? Because they just charge a low, flat monthly fee to handle your credit card processing. You'll save money. We use it at the Amato Center. We've got hundreds, I don't know, maybe 1,000 or more now dental practices all across the U.S. Using Stacks by Fat Merchant for their processing, and they're saving. You want to find out how much you'll save? Just go to Amato.com/save. Well, that makes sense. Amato.com/save. Your first month of processing will be just $5. Wow, such a deal. So I hope you do that. Amato.com/save. Okay, let me tell you a little bit about my dishwasher and what it has to do with your dental practice. Well, a few days ago, our dishwasher broke. I think water stopped coming in. So at the end of the cycle, the dishes will be hot, but they wouldn't be clean, and the little soap pod didn't dissolve. So I pretty much figured there was no water coming in. I just like you probably do, I Googled around and went to some sites, and I decided that this was not something I wanted to fix. Here in Baltimore, when an appliance or anything breaks, we say it went up. I don't know if that means like it went up to heaven. I don't know if the origin of that phrase is, but in true Baltimore spirit, I'll say, my dishwasher went up. My dishwasher went up. That's how somebody would, in old time, East Baltimorean would say it. My dishwasher just went up. So anyway, my dishwasher went up. Okay, so we need to call a dishwasher repair person because my wife and I don't like doing the dishes, even though we actually wash the dishes before we put them in the dishwasher, which makes no sense, but we wanted to get this done. And let's face it, a dishwasher breaking is not the end of the world. I mean, it's a first world problem, as some people might say, but on the other hand, to us, it was a minor emergency. We don't want to go without a dishwasher. So we have bought our appliances from the same store for many, many years. It's a mom and pop store. I know the owner. Everybody there is super nice, good pricing, great service department, easy to deal with, all those things. And I think it makes you feel good also to go to a local mom and pop store as opposed to a Best Buy or Amazon or Home Depot or whatever when it comes to your appliances. So that was great. So I wanted to call this store to get service. We've used their service department before. Now, first of all, I was really surprised that they didn't open until 10 p.m. I think, you know, maybe if the showroom opens at 10 p.m., that's one thing. But to me, you should be able to call the service department much earlier. I'd say 8 a.m., 7 a.m. I mean, I was raring to call at 6 a.m., but, you know, the very least 8:30 or 9 a.m. So I had to wait till 10 a.m. Meanwhile, probably all the other service places who opened at 8:30 or 9 or had online scheduling, their appointments were being booked. So by the time I got through at 10 a.m., they told me that they could see me in about a week. I think it was about 8 days, actually. Now, again, I know this is not an emergency when it comes down to true life emergencies, but we wanted our dishwasher to be fixed before the weekend. 8 days just wasn't going to cut it. So I made the appointment. Kind of reluctantly, I noticed something was a little different about the way they were handling the phone calls too. They just seemed to have gotten a little more corporate. They weren't maybe as mom and pop or friendly as I remember them. But anyway, I made the appointment. Then we live in a condo building. I'm walking down the halls of my condo and coming the other way is our great residence liaison, Alexis. And I said to her, hey, Alex, is there an appliance repair person that you recommend? And she said, well, who have you been using? I said, and I'm changing all these names to protect the innocent, so to speak, even Alexis's name. It's not really her name. But so she said, who do you usually use? And I said, well, we've been using glass appliances for years, but they can't see us until next week. And she said, glass appliances? Never heard of them. You should try Allied Appliances. I know a lot of people in the building are familiar with them. Give them a call or you can book right on their website. So what did I do? I went on their website, booked. I got an appointment for the next day. I was psyched, but I was even more psyched when about 5 minutes later, my cell phone rang and it was a very friendly person from Allied Appliances. They just wanted to review some things, double check the address, see what's going on. It was a super friendly call. Really, really nice thing to do. I was impressed. I was even more impressed when they asked this question next, which I think was a killer question. They said something like, as long as our tech is going to be out there looking at your dishwasher, are there any other appliances you would like him to look at? I said, yeah, you know what? As a matter of fact, our dryer's been making some weird noises. Can he take a look at our dryer? Boom. She said, absolutely. We'll include that in the diagnostic fee as well. Great. Now I'm excited tomorrow for this tech to come out to look at our dishwasher and our dryer. Wow, everything's fantastic. So let's talk about a few great dental practice things that just happened here. Some dental practice lessons. First of all, glass appliances. The first store didn't open till 10 a.m. We already talked about that. To me, that is unacceptable. You've got to make it easy for people to do business with you. Make it easy for your patients to schedule. Open at 9, open at 8:30. No voicemails that say we're currently seeing other patients or we're currently at lunch, blah, 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 blah. No way. Online scheduling is great if you can pull it off. Just make it easy for your patients to appoint. Glass couldn't get us in same day or next day. So what happened? I went to someone else. It's the same with your new patients. It might not be a true emergency if a so-called emergency patient calls, but to them, it is an emergency. A minor toothache, a chipped tooth, a lost restoration, whatever it is, or anyone. Even if somebody just realizes, hey, it's time I got a cleaning, get them in right away, because if not, they will lose interest. Then they'll talk to somebody else, and somebody else will say exactly what Alexis said to me. Never heard of them. According to our friend, Dr. Mitchell Josephs, those are the four most dangerous words in dentistry. The scenario he always paints is somebody makes an appointment for your office. They call, you can't get them in for a couple of weeks. They're at a cocktail party, a softball game for their kids, whatever. And the topic of dentistry comes up. They say, oh yeah, I just made an appointment with Dr. Matto. I say, Dr. Matto, never heard of him. You got to see my guy or my gal. Hands on their card, whatever, mentions their name. They can see you the next day and boom. You've just lost a patient and didn't even know it. So you got to get patients in right away. And it's great to do things in your community so the people have heard of you, of course. That's a topic for another day. But you don't want those four most dangerous words, never heard of him or never heard of her, said about you. So again, Allied made it easy to schedule. Glass didn't. Then, even though I scheduled online, they call back right away, which obviously you're going to have to do in your dental practice if somebody schedules online because you need some more information, but great, do it. And then they ask the killer question. As long as the tech is out there, is there anything else you would like him to look at? Sure. Take a look at my dryer. It's been making some funny noises. You know what? I hope this doesn't happen, but what if we need a new dishwasher and a new dryer? That's like a $2,500 to $3,000 customer or case, as we would say in dentistry, that the old appliance store would have had and now the new appliance store could potentially have because they did things right. So one more tip to learn from this is when a new patient or a potential new patient is on the phone, after you make the appointment, say to them, is there anybody else in your family who needs an appointment? You will be amazed how frequently they'll make appointments for their kids or their spouse, or if they're a single person, you know, they might recommend you to another family member or to a friend or to a work colleague. It always is a great technique to make sure that a new patient knows that you are ready and willing not just to serve them, but anybody else who they know that's looking for a great dentist. So, wow, that is my lesson that I learned today for our dental practices from my dishwasher of all things. Crazy. I love learning customer service lessons from other service businesses, other professions, restaurants, anyone, you name it. Every business is a service business, and some businesses really, really step up and do a great job, and others just don't. So when that happens, let's use those as lessons. Okay, that's our little dental office parable for today. Now, along the same lines, I have one secret shopper call for you this week. I'm trying to go over here to Command Central to get it lined up, but Command Central isn't cooperating. Come on, come on. Oh, no. There goes Command Central. Command Central is actually my MacBook. So along the same lines, I called a dental office and had a little minor emergency, maybe not that big of a deal. But again, to me, it was a big deal. I pretended it was actually for my wife. Let's see what happens. Let's see if they can get me in right away. Let's see if they do anything else that just didn't sound quite right. Okay, secret shopper call for this week, for this podcast. Let's hit it.
New patient or would like information regarding scheduling an appointment, please press 2.
Answer!
Office.
Hi, I have a question for you. I'm calling on behalf of my wife. She, I think, lost a filling and it's a little bit uncomfortable on that tooth. How quickly can you get her in to take a look at that, you think?
And are you an existing patient?
No, I don't exist.
Is she a new patient?
Yes.
So we're pretty booked. So and we're going away. So.
Oh, where are you going?
We're going to Cancun. So let me just see.
Nice.
Hold on. So what insurance does she have? Do you know?
I don't know.
Oh, okay. So. See, we might be able to. Is it a large filling? Is it hurting her?
It's a little bit uncomfortable. I wouldn't say it's like hurting, but it's a little.
She may need a root canal if it's bothering her.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, if it's hurting her, she may need a root canal. So when you say filling, it could be down to her nerve if she's feeling it.
Oh, wow, that sounds horrible.
Root canal, you can save the tooth. But I'm just saying, if it's hurting her, that's what's happening. Mm-hmm. We don't have an opening. I can take an x-ray and take a look at it tomorrow morning, maybe. See what's going on with it.
Okay, what time do you think that would be?
9:15.
9:15. Okay, I'll tell you what. I'm going to check with her schedule. I'll be able to text her immediately, and I'll call you right back. How's that?
Okay, and what's your wife's name?
Her name is Elizabeth Vandelay. Vandelay, Vandalay.
Okay, got it, Vandelay. Okay, great. Got it.
I'll get right back to you. Thank you so much.
Bye-bye.
Oh, boy. That was, I would say, a disaster. A total disaster. Now, you can't say she wasn't nice. She was nice. But what is going on here? I mean, I called. I said, my wife's having an emergency. Can you get her in? And, it's funny. After all that ridiculous conversation, she was able to get her in the next day at 9:15. It's not great. I think same day is much better, but it's not horrible. I mean, look, I'm not saying that she's screaming in pain and bleeding from her ears, So same next day at 9:15 is not horrible. Why didn't she lead with that? Why didn't she first of all say, yes, we can get her in. Let's see her 9:15 tomorrow morning. How's that? And then get the other information. I don't understand why she didn't do that. But she should have done it for the same day, but geez, at the very least, after 2 minutes and 58 seconds of total BS, she actually could get her in. This just made no sense to me. So again, this should have been a completely different call. My wife's having an emergency. She lost a filling. It's a little uncomfortable. Can you see her? Absolutely, yes. We'd love to see her. We can do it at 9:15 tomorrow morning, then get some other information. Are you an existing patient? Is she an existing patient? I know that has to be done eventually, but I think there are much better ways to do that. When was the last time you were in? Just, nicer, more friendly way. And then she said, we're pretty booked. We're going on vacation. Negative, negative, negative. And then What insurance does she have? I mean, why do you even assume that somebody has dental insurance? Of course you need that information, but let's get the appointment booked and show our friendliness and love and courtesy before we start getting into those types of questions. And then I have no idea why she went there, but she was starting to do the diagnosis over the phone. How large is the filling? It might need a root canal. It could be down to the nerve. Why was she saying any of this? The patient has no idea. You have no idea because you can't diagnose over the phone. Get the patient in, then you'll see. You'll learn all of this. It just was totally ridiculous. And then at the very end, it turns out she could get her in a pretty decent amount of time. But by then, I've completely lost interest. Wow, what a crazy call. And there was some good potential there too, but I would say this was completely a disaster. You know, we don't fix this. We don't cherry pick it, but it seems like most of the calls we do on the podcast fall into that category. I'm sorry to say, but hopefully we learned a lot, both from this call and from my dishwasher, as we say here in Baltimore. So that's going to do it for today. I'm Dr. Richard Matto. I'm co-founder of the Matto Center for Dental Practice Success. Thanks so much for listening to the Dental Practice Fixers. Check us out at matto.com, M-A-D-O-W.com. We've got some cool upcoming things that I know you want to find out about. And I will see you soon. Thanks. Bye.